Second quarter has begun. We're tied at 13. Very defensive battle. First quarter. The glass too high for Davis. As the other Davis of St. Francis comes out. Baldwin. Nice pass. Missed it inside. Here comes the Crusaders. Kicks the pass. And a foul. Don't have to shoot too.
Well, it's right on St. Francis that he's offensive to get going. Well,
Robert
got out in the
backboard
in the past. I think we need a little bit more ball movement.
Number one.
I haven't seen too much ball movement. Then we get inside, they gotta finish. They've had some key opportunities and he's been missing. But just gotta finish.
A lot of open threes going to come and go, but not some down. You're going to miss some, but around the rim, you got to finish. Double effect, if you can't get them to back the line. Ball in hands, and now St. Francis down by two again. Inside, and a foul. Now you have it again, another round of rim shot not finished, bailed out by the foul.
7-12, number 21, Allen Griffin, first personal, 15 fouls. On the line for the Panthers, number 11, Errol Penn, shooting two.
Penn with a pair here. Oh, man.
Returning for the Panthers, number 4, Elijah Hatch.
Check on Price is Right.
Round and round goes.
Yep. Second shot to get this game back within one. He does. 1 point affair between the Crusaders of Archbishop Stepinac.
St. Francis coming out with the first trap of the game on the press.
For three. Gotta get that rebound. It does.
Both teams are pretty cool from behind the 3 point line.
Speaking of three, that's the one that goes in.
Elijah for three.
Mr. Epps is shooting a high percentage going back to last night's game as well from behind the arc.
That gives Francis a 2 point lead. Wow. Here comes St. Francis trying to increase that 2 point lead.
That's good transition.
Why not?
Woo!
Transitional timeout.
George Gordon had 4 3-pointers last night. Continue with hot shooting behind the arc.
6:25 left, 20-15. And
I don't think he is, Coach.
Started last night. He got off to a hot start.
Thorne Moore was one that was raved over here, though, but it seemed like, I don't know, compared right now, he's not in the lineup.
He'll be back with the team next week, Coach. Right now, he's not here.
I want to St. Francis, by the way, get Archbishop Spalding in this building on Monday.
Yeah, he had some family issues. He'll be back for basketball next week. Absolutely. Talented player. We had a little assistant there from Coach C of the St. Francis JV Varsity program.
We got to get into Chesapeake's JV. How you guys looking to get some guys to come up and be with you?
Well, I had coached AAU for a couple seasons, and six players from my AAU team were sophomores on my Chesapeake JV team. But they're so good that Varsity took three of them. And now I have three of them. I have three experienced ball players and a bunch of okay ball players, so we'll see how it goes.
Change of baskets. 1-3 was dropped and then a 2. On the other end, it puts St. Francis up. Getting it on the offensive end. And for three. Oh, man.
They're heating up, man.
They are both teams starting to hit them. and it's a one-point game again. Very highly entertaining game.
Pass.
Nice pass. Oh, just didn't go in, perhaps. It was the right shot.
How that pass?
Oh, the defense got back, though, in time.
Stolen.
Stolen indeed. Trapped. And a bailout foul.
Oh, foul.
Oh.
Like he had his own.
Returning for the Panthers, number one, Adrian Baldwin. Returning for the Crusaders, number zero, Jordan Davis.
Early in the year, when teams were trying to fill out themselves and trying to
find their identities,
this game here is a contrast of teams that still trying to find what they are, but also their offensive players. Oh.
Jordan Cole, that was not Jordan. As I stated before, he had 4 3 last night. The team is hot shooting from behind the arc.
Crusaders.
Man, he went in. I give him credit.
He attacked the rim like there was no Mutombo back there.
Returning for the Crusaders, number three, Peyton Hudson. For the Panthers, number 22, Yami Adoma.
4:41 left in the first half as Davis hits them both.
25-23, right? Competitive game.
Oh, like you're just talking about. Oh, he got it in one!
Nabi Adoma.
22 Nabi, the transfer from Reynolds Town Senior High.
It's
going to be a big help to the St. Francis team. Yeah, hype. Powered up with an and one there.
We were just talking about how they wasn't able to get shots inside and finally got one to bounce off.
And finished. Free throw good by Nabi. The Randall's down the transfer.
Quick 30-second timeout. Coming up after this one, we got a good one here in the St. Benedict Cracker. Silver Bees up against Mount St. Joe Gales. Gales are the top team here in the Baltimore Metro, and Silver Bees are ranked nationally in USA Today and Max Prep. What you think about that?
I think St. Joe will continue to compete for all championships, BCL, MIA. Riley will be Jones Curl, the great two guards, quickly play of the year. And the transfer coming from Oak Hill, Montez.
Yeah, Montez Rapp is, was that Mount Carmel back in town?
Right. And he's hooked up with quickly.
Ooh, that's
play of the year and John Curl, but they're under a new coach this year, so we have to give Mount St. Joe the edge. Behind the helm.
St. Joe's remembers that buzzer beater shot at Towson last year. See it right here on our DSN on YouTube.
Coaching means a lot.
Tony
Martin,
ready.
We'll see how they're
fighting. Now, what happened to Coach Martin? I didn't hear about that.
Coach Martin was out of college offer in South Carolina, and he took it. And he left the program, and John Carroll has taken his role. UMBC assistant coach coming to take over.
Another three pops in. Trapping almost at the center court. 4 minutes left. 2-point game for Francis. For three. That one tips and misses. Here comes the Crusaders. Turnover. Lays it in. 30-26.
Jordan Goodwin for two.
For three again.
Stepinac.
Somebody transferred from Randall's town.
That's what I did. I said on YouTube, you check out that fourth quarter, one of the better play fourth quarters I've seen in a long time. And that game up bounced from 5, I'll tell you. Quickly, it's amazing. And Daryl Moore is going to Maryland. He's been there about a month ago. From Mount St. Joe's. Very interesting matchup coming up. And then next Saturday, Pauley Mount St. Joe's at the William Wells Classic.
That's going to be interesting. Pauley had a great year last year. Point guard was a freshman, the fourth point guard to start at St. Benedict High School. The other ones were Jason Williams, the beat. Isaiah Bristol, the band from Kentucky. There was two other ones before him as well.
How about that?
Nationally ranked program, they were in the Classic, I think, 2 years ago.
Talked to the coach last night. He said they were ranked 13th, but two, three of the teams in front of him, they pounded about 20-plus points. So if you can read between the lines, Coach Meyer thought they were a better ranked team.
Yeah, I would definitely think so. Also, that's a three. That one misses. So the Crusaders trying to get themselves back on track. Oh, and Duke. Man, they're raining them in, aren't they?
Watching for three.
Outside game of both teams seems to be much improved over the inbound. Over the inside game, sorry, sir.
I said it's about both teams as game action is back here. The fouls are not high yet, even though the Crusaders are at the point where they foul Francis again in free throws, like it is now. The 1-1 at least.
Speaking of
foul, they got upended by Woodlawn in the 3A playoffs, like 4A playoffs.
Yes, they did. St. Benedict walks in as we're shooting free throws. We have St. Francis Academy. A lot of 6'10 guys coming in.
That is a tall team as you get them here on camera now. That's a tall lineup. Hits them both. 34-29, 5-point game for the Panthers. Almost a costly turnover. Hudson. Cuts over, number three. Hits again. Keeping the Crusaders in the game. A 2-point game. Every time St. Francis tried to get a little room, that three ball just dropping in.
Crusaders down up three.
Shoots it. Tipped and missed. Offensive rebound. Off the glass. Oh, man.
As we spoke of before, a lot of missed opportunities inside.
With these threes dropping for the Crusaders, that could come back and bite St. Francis at the end of this game. Hudson has the ball now, bringing it out for the Crusaders. In the dark blue uniforms. St. Francis in the yellow this afternoon. Another three, why not? Hits it again, claims it. And the Crusaders can take the lead back for the first time in the second quarter.
Definitely keeping the Crusaders in the game.
It's now giving them the lead. A lot of dribbling there by Goodwin. He's able to get it over to Davis. Terrell Davis is nice. Epps with 13 on the shot clock.
The three-point shoot as well. The pass by
the pass.
There's the finish.
Yes, sir.
Oh, pass for two.
And more beautiful than a great pass and a good finish. A little more than a minute left. He walked.
Definitely call it around here in Baltimore. 57 seconds remaining in the first half. 36-35 St. Francis.
Oh man. Nice hands to avoid the turnover. Oh yeah. Yes, it is. Tim Duncan would like it. Jones with three. Wooden Francis. Oh. Side. Coming out to shoot a pin. 7 foul against St. Francis.
Jordan
Reed's
on the line for the Crusaders.
Oh, Mr. First miss today.
The Panthers,
the Crusaders.
One shot remaining.
Second shot. That one missed too. It was a good pass, but got shook. 3-2 for three. Hits it! That's a buzzer! At halftime, St. Francis up by the slimmest of margins, 1 point over the Archbishop Stepinac Crusaders. And we'll be back with the second half of this here on the Diasporting Network on YouTube.